Ah, ¿me puede salir un link? ¿Can you hear me? Is everything working? Let me see. Hello, everybody. I'm trying to fix the last technical thing so we can all have a smooth webinar. Let me see, because I'm not completely familiar with this technical stuff. So I'm trying to fix everything. Let's see. So I'm sorry again, give me a few seconds more. Let's see. Yes, the final things. Okay. So I think everything is ready. Just let me check the last thing. Okay, so I'm gonna get started. Welcome everybody. Let me see if I can show myself because I'm just here to show you the table. Let me see if I go down here and maybe you can see me. Well, hello everybody. Let me see if you can see me. It's difficult because I have everything organized for the webinar. Okay. I was trying to hear Lin, but I don't know. It seems to be something is not properly set. And okay, Lin, just text me if you are ready, okay? And I'll start the webinar. So I know that everything is running smoothly over there. So what we can do, because I can't hear anybody here of the people that are invited, so let's see how so there may be a way to do it. Okay, so let's get started. So this is the first Encaustic CUNY webinar. I'm gonna just make a fast historical introduction. We made a lot of studies on Roman paintings, on encaustic painting, and just for just have a book. I'll show you a very quick let's see so we can see it all. So okay. So I think so you can see this. This book is very heavy. Okay. So these are Roman wall paintings that were all painted with encaustic. This is what we study in order to reproduce the formula. Okay, we know that all the Roman and Greek paintings were painted with encaustic, a formula that was lost with the fall of the Roman Empire, and that a lot of studies have been done since the Renaissance to try to recover the paint to be able to paint like the Romans painted and the Greeks. So anyway, so what I'm here is to show you the properties of the paint. So we are going to do a couple of quick things. I have these two things. I have this piece of cardboard, okay, and I have this canvas. This is just a commercial canvas ready, you know, ready to paint. It's a very poor quality, actually, but I like to test those things to see how encaustic works with the with the cheap stuff sometimes, because sometimes these kind of canvas that don't work very well with acrylic, for example, because it repels water. I'll change this so I can maybe put the light a little bit closer. Hope you can see this. Let me move the camera a little bit more. Okay. So I'll put a little more light. Hope it's enough light. Let me move this one. Okay. Okay, so I guess we should be fine now. Anyway, okay, so let's start with the canvas. I'm gonna do just the chiaroscuro painting. This means like a technique used by, let's say, Renaissance painters and up to the 1800s. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna give a wash to the whole background with, let's see, with a yellow ochre, which I have here, and also, so I have the yellow ochre. I'm gonna give it a wash. So the good thing about encaustic is that the solvent is water. So here we have the water that we are gonna use. And so I take a little bit of the kind of, let's see, and just a little bit there. I'm gonna get maybe a little bit of, no, this is okay for now. Okay, so now with a bigger brush that I should have here, I'm gonna paint it back. Yes, with this brush, okay, I'm gonna get some water. I'm going, yes, color the background to have fun. Maybe I can add more. It's a little table to work with. I'm gonna add some sienna. Okay. So this is just a wash for the background to keep this very colorful. Okay, so more water. Okay. Really, I'm gonna paint the all the wires because the way I have the camera. Okay. Keep going. It's too bad that I can't hear anybody so I can answer questions, but I'll try to make it fun for everybody to hear. And okay, and the water. Okay, so now I have the background. So now I can do two things. One is just let it dry, you know, by evaporation of the water, or just to accelerate the process, I'm gonna use hair dryer, okay, which I have here. So I'm gonna use this. For two reasons. One is because it's gonna dry faster, so I can paint in top of this once it's dry. And two, because also heat helps to seal the paint and make it unsolvable faster. So in other words, it cures faster. So I'm gonna have to unplug one of the lights because I don't have so many plugs. But I guess that should be fine just for this, because this takes a few seconds as well. Yeah. And so it's gonna be noisy. Put it in time. So I don't know if you feel me, but I'm applying heat. Let's keep dry faster so we can wear. Okay, so That's it for now. So now it's dry and it's ready for me to paint. And also, because I wanna. Okay, so this is dry and ready to paint. Okay, because this and now yes, so it will be dry too. I'm gonna prepare that cardboard. So I have this thick cardboard. Okay, and I like this color very much for painting, as a background for painting. Since this is cardboard, it's very absorbent, so it's difficult to paint on it. So what I'm gonna do in this case is move things out of here. What I'm gonna do is we have encaustic medium, and I'm gonna use it as a I like to apply it with a palette knife, but you can also apply it with brush. So just gonna go over the blackboard. So this is gonna allow me to have a very nice surface for painting, because this is then the paint runs very smoothly and very nicely over this surface. Okay, just gonna just make sure that I cover everything. Okay. So you see that you don't need much of the medium, like it covers a lot, okay? So let's cover, okay. So we're gonna take a little more and put it over here. Okay. I like to think this is fun. Okay, very nice. So that it really gives me a very nice surface for painting in top. Okay. Just want to make sure that I'm covering everything. And it's still too bad that I can't answer questions, but hopefully next time, which hopefully also will be very soon, we will know how this thing works better, so we can exchange questions, opinions, whatever you have. Okay, so this is ready. I can either use the hair dryer or not. So since I'm gonna start painting the other painting, just let it dry until we do the other one. Okay, so just clean this and put this to dry somewhere else. Okay, now, so we're gonna do the painting, as I said, using chiaroscuro technique developed during the Renaissance. Okay, see, so I need, when I use a raw amber that I have, let me see where we are. It's here. Oh, that's a fine thing. So I'm gonna put one a little bit in the palette. Okay, so put some raw amber here, and just a little bit of water. So we just want a liquid for the drawing. So let's see. Okay. Nice. We can. Okay, just a very fast drawing. Little bit more water. Okay. Of course, you can use these for, you know, anything you want to paint. Yeah, it doesn't have to be necessarily this. But since this is a very traditional way of painting, I think it's going to give us a nice example of how we can do this. Okay. Let's see here. A little bit of hair. And also, since this is basically what we are doing is a test of how this, you know, webinar, this Google program works. Also, by next time I do one, you can write down all the questions that you have, and so we can and I can answer them. Okay, because probably after this you will have a lot of questions. But actually, I'm very happy that we got it started, because I think this is a very good way of knowing how the paint works, you know, the different painting techniques, the different things we can make. And I don't know either how it's exactly the quality of the image. I need to find more, you know, to see how you can get the best image quality, so you can see the texture of the paint and, you know, the details. Okay, so here. Okay, so trying to go fast so we can do a lot of things today. Because also I don't want to keep you all day in front of the camera. So since I know most of you are like in Taiwan, China, and so probably you will go soon to bed. And I don't want to keep you all night awake. Okay, so now I have the basic drawing, and now I'm gonna start doing the chiaroscuro, which basically works, the same. So one of the reasons I want the background dry is because when I apply the painting top, I don't want it to mix with the background. Let's see, this brush, need another brush. Because that way the colors keep very, very clean. Let's see, need another brush. Because that doesn't look like that. Yeah, let's see. Okay, and this, I'll use this one. Yeah, because it's bigger just to go faster. Covering the this brush is not good either. It's okay for now. See, there's at least to cover the big areas. Okay, so I'm making it transparent over the layer in the background. We get another brush. Let's see. Okay, so I'm going to cover it to the background. Okay, so that's for the background. And now I'm going to start with the chiaroscuro. Thank you. me move the water to the other side. It's gonna be easier for me. So now I'm going to do a little bit of fabric. So also, you know, what is important, like if you've been painting, for example, with oil, it will take you a little while, you know, to get accustomed to things that dry faster. So if you use oils and you have used acrylic, you are kind of familiar with this technique because it has a drying time similar to acrylics, with one difference that is acrylics, once you dry, you cannot move them. So if you wanna, like, I mean, you can, like, for example, erase a color. In this case, until the paint completely cures, you can still rework what you have painted, okay? It gives you more control over the things that you are painting. Give more paint. See, looks a little bit mad. I'll have to fix that. And see what goes at me. And also the beautiful thing, like I was talking about acrylics. One of a lot of people use acrylics, yes, because you can work, you know, much faster because it dries much faster than oil. But then the quality is very poor because, you know, at the end of the day, it's just plastic, and so the luminosity properties are very poor. The very nice thing about encaustic is that since it's beeswax, and the color keeps always very, very pure and very clean and very beautiful. And now I'm gonna do, let's see, this other brush. Let me see. Here. then, okay, back. Oops. Sorry. And also, if you have any suggestions on, you know, how it's better for you, like, or for me to show. To solve this, so you can see it better, maybe there is another better way. You can also tell me for next time, so I can set things in a different way. Okay. So keep working here on my chiaroscuro. Very fast. You see, I'm using the paint with almost no water, yes, because I like that quality of the paint. Okay. Okay, so it's that. Here. Okay, so that's for now. Then I can start applying color. I'm gonna just let it dry while I show you the cardboard. Okay, you can see that's nice and have a very nice surface to paint, as I will show you. And so, okay, so now with a different palette, let's see something bright. Let's use this is Nathol red, okay, which is a very bright red. I'm gonna take a little bit, put it in my palette, and let me see, I'm gonna take a little bit of white here. Put some white there. And also, you see, this paint is very nice and creamy. You can really do nice, you can do from very nice transparencies to like thick impastos. Okay, that's a color. Let me see. I'm gonna make another one. Let's do something very bright. Let's use this. Have here ultramarine blue. Okay, I'm gonna use I'm gonna use it with white. And this is just, you know, a little bit of everything to show you different possibilities. So this one is gonna be using thicker paint. We have, mix it with a little white. Okay.
So that way, that way.
Okay.
So this is conk. I like to paint pink and see with brush, like for example, this one. Now, it's let me see if I can show it to you closer, because I really like, you know, how nice and thick you can do it. I'm gonna use more blue, you get more. I'm gonna get also, I guess, yeah, it's really bad that I can't hear anybody. I hope for next day, we will try to organize another one very soon, so we can, you know, hear each other. Okay. So you see this runs so smooth in this surface. I really like that. Okay. For example, and now I'm gonna clean the brush very well. Oh, it's almost 9:20. Well, I'm gonna do it a little longer, okay? So because we started a little late. So now I'm gonna use pink. A nice pink. Let me get more white. What is my what here? So I don't know, maybe showing this vertical is gonna be easier for you to see. I don't know, we have to try those things and tell me what you think. Okay, so I guess between all of us, we can make a very nice webinars. Okay. So I'll show you here. Okay. I love these. I love this paint. It's so cool to paint with it. So it breathes. And then you can hold both things. So I got this, I got that. Okay, we're getting there. Now let me use some green, for example. So you get some green. So I have here some green, put it here, and we're going to use a little bit of purple. Oh, so this is dioxin purple. What? Am I showing to you? No. Okay. It's difficult to see what I'm doing in the camera. Okay.
bit here. Uh-huh, that's what I'm cool. Anyway. Let's see, just working very fast, but it's also a lot of fun. Okay. Because these pens help you to work fast and easy. Okay, so now going wide over here. Using here green and purple together. It's super, super gorgeous. But anyway. Okay, that's very fast. Now I'm gonna use just white. Yeah, and please write all your questions. And so next day, you know, I can answer them. Because I'm so accustomed to use this paint. Like sometimes I think like everybody knows the answers just because I know them, and I know that is not true. So. It's, you know, you can do like here very beautiful stuff. Okay. Well, just, you know, this is an example of things that you can do. Okay, so now I'm gonna go over the other painting. You see, everything is falling because this is a small table, because otherwise couldn't fit. That's why maybe, I don't know, and like putting things on an easel, and so I can have more space. But then I think the image is gonna be too far away and you are gonna see details. Let me get this closer so you can see. I don't know how good the detail you can see. But this is, you know, such a nice surface for painting. Never really liked it. Okay, and now just very, very fast. And just kind of, you know, show a little finish with this. So I'll do gonna do skin color. Let me do it. Here is okay. And also, I hope you can hear me well. I don't know, maybe the volume is too low, maybe it's too high. Okay, so I'm gonna use for the face color yellow ochre and a little bit of the Nathol red, okay. Here, here, just a little bit. And I'm gonna make a nice
skin color. Okay, I'll tip of this. Sometimes I realize that I'm not in front of the camera. Put a little more white, or yeah. Okay. Now I think it's too pink, needs a little more yellow ochre, a tiny bit. Oops, let's see. And let's a little more white. Oops, there's some purple on it. Okay. Let me see with brass. I'm going to use this clear. Yeah, like this, because it allows you to make nice velaturas. And I think I need a little more white. Yeah, I don't know if you see, like, I'm looking in my computer and I see that, I don't think you can see the, detail so much. So you can see the texture of the paint, etc. But okay, a little more. Let me white. It's dry. So you know, yeah. Paint dries in your palette knife. Just put a little bit of water, and just with the paper towel, you can take it away. Okay. I'm gonna use more lighter. Highlights. And another thing that I want to do is to go over these techniques, but going each one by each one, so you can learn them, because of these painting techniques are very important, you know, in for not just using a paint, but to use the technique that allows you to control the paint and the finish that you want for your paintings. And for example, here that is already a little dry. Yes, a tiny bit of water. Yeah, yes, you can dilute it again. Okay, go for it. Little by little. I think I was gonna do a couple more details. We will leave it for today. And hopefully next day, which will be very soon, we'll resolve all the technical issues, and I'll have all the recommendation. By the way, this is carbon black, okay? So by next day, we will have things set in a way where you can see better, I can hear your questions, and all of that stuff. For example, here, this is important, because black is very black, that's a lot of pigment. And I wanna paint this black, but I wanna make it transparent, so it doesn't cover completely the background, because I like this background and I want it to show it through. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna mix the black with medium in my palette, okay? And see, if I take a little bit of medium, put it here, I'll take a little bit of black and just mix it. Okay, so with the medium gives me, because I do it with water, it's gonna look like almost like a watercolor. But if I do it with medium, still the paint is very thick and very rich, but I see sometimes I'm out of the camera. So the paint is still thick and rich, but it's more transparent, which is what I need in this case for my background. It's here, here. So another thing that I like of this paint is that it doesn't destroy the brushes. Like either like with oil or the turpentine, the brushes doesn't last very long. Also acrylic, because acrylic has, those alcohols. For example, all the bristle brushes get destroyed very, very fast too. They get hard and easy to break. Okay. Anyway, so it's really start looking like something. I need to work more on her face so it doesn't look a little prettier. Okay. I'm gonna make it. Okay. Also, it's difficult to paint with the camera between my arms. Well, I think it should be all for today. I'm sure, you know, we can go over 1,000 things here in terms of material and different uses for the encaustic, painting techniques, different surfaces for painting. So it will be very helpful if you write all your questions, and maybe you can mail me your questions, so I have a long list with your questions, and I can organize them and answer them with specific exercises, so it's easier for you to understand. Okay, and anything you want to ask is good. Don't be afraid of ask stupid questions. There are no stupid questions, really, because everything is gonna be interesting, and it's gonna be very interesting for me to answer. So thank you very much for being here with me, and it was a great pleasure. Maybe next time I can also show my face while I paint. We will see. I don't know if that is important. Anyway, thank you very much for everything, and I hope you enjoy it. What I see is that the light reflects on the canvas is difficult to see. But anyway, you can see just a little bit of how, you know, the paint works, what we can do. Anyway, thank you so much. I'll talk with Lin, and between both of us, we organize the next webinar. And and you can have all your questions. You can either email her or email me for the questions. Okay. And nothing. Thank you so much for being with me. Have a great day or night over there, because I'm just starting my day. And I will see you very soon, everybody. Okay. Thank you so much. And I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.